Please tell me I wasn't the only one that thought of Dragon Ball Z when Luffy said you need to hold him off for 10 minutes. Like, please tell me. I am not the only one that thought that, because in this chapter of One Piece, when Luffy's just sitting there and he's like, I can't use my Haki for 10 minutes, I can't use the Pound Man for 10 minutes because, you know, I'm worn out and I can't use Haki or anything. I instantly thought of Dragon Ball Z. He's like, you need to hold him off for 10 minutes. I instantly thought of, like, Goku, you know, charging up, Vegeta having to hold his own, and or, you know, Goku's having to charge Spirit Bomb, and Piccolo's having to hold off Frieza. That's what I thought of when I saw this chapter. Instantly in my mind, when I saw this 10-minute timer, I'm like, oh, God, these guys are fucked, they're fucked, they're fucked. Because these gladiators from the Colosseum, I'm, like, almost 99% certain none of them could stand up to Doffy. Let's be absolute real here. Like, do you really think these gladiators can hold off against Doffy? Like, dude, Doffy still gets up after getting hit by the Pound Man. Like, nah. These gladiators, they might stand a little bit of a chance, but Doffy's too powerful. I just don't think those gladiators can hold off for even 2 minutes. I don't think so. I really doubt it, but we'll have to see. Jesus Burgess, he makes once again an appearance in this chapter, and he's like, I want to get your devil fruit, Straw Hat Luffy. And so we kind of know what Burgess's goal is currently at the moment. He wants to get the devil fruit from Luffy. You gotta love how Burgess just gets bitch slapped in this chapter. He just gets slung off to the side by Sabo, just kicks his ass, and he just goes flying off. So very funny. Like, I mean, the Blackbeard Pirates Jesus Burgess, he's not really living up to the hype as I thought, because right now, he's just getting his ass beat, like, straight up getting his ass beat. So hopefully he will be able to hold off Sabo or something, because to increase the tension right here, it'd be really cool if Sabo has to focus completely on Burgess, and then the gladiators have to fight off and protect, you know, Luffy against Doffy for 10 minutes. That would be a really epic fight. And then we also have to factor in Fujitora. I mean, what's Fujitora gonna do? Is he gonna also fight, or is he just gonna sit back? A lot of questions right now, but with this chapter, it's kind of setting up for the finale, the final confrontation between Doffy versus Luffy, or Sabo and Luffy versus Doffy. Just this right here, this chapter was set up for the final battle of this arc. And I know a lot of fellow readers of One Piece are probably getting very hyped up about this, because One Piece usually goes down this path. It usually has a very good explosive beginning that's really setting up the arc. It has a slow middle, which Dressrosa has had that happen to it. And then the ending segment of the arc usually is very explosive, action-packed, and has a lot of things going down. And that's currently what we are seeing at the moment with Gear 4 to also what is going on with the Pound Man Luffy not being able to use Haki for 10 minutes, and then, you know, seeing Sabo come in, fighting Jesus Burgess, and then also trying to protect his brother. So yeah, I mean, this chapter was mainly just building up the hype for the finale. And you have to wonder, I mean, how's it gonna go down? Because is it gonna be done by Luffy transforming again? Like, I mean, is Luffy going to be able to go back into his Pound Man Gear 4 state? Or is he going to, you know, I guess not be able to transform again and go to Gear 4, and Sabo or the other gladiators are probably going to finish him off? See, there's a lot of variables we have to factor in right now, because it can go any direction. I mean, right now, Doffy is weak, and he's extremely weak, and he's not at maximum potential as he usually is. And for Sabo being there, and we know how strong Sabo is, he could possibly take out Doffy since he is weakened. The big wild card right now is Burgess. That is really the big wild card when it comes to this chapter, because Burgess, right now, from the moment from what we were seeing, he's just getting his ass beat. He's just getting fucking kicked. His ass is getting destroyed. But that right there might surprise us, because, I mean, we gotta figure this out, okay? That might be, like, a little bit of a sham that Oda's trying to show us, like, that Burgess is not that big of a threat, but it turns out that Burgess is going to be incredibly powerful, pull off some form of skills, and start fighting Sabo and holding him back, and Sabo's having to focus all his attention on Burgess while he's trying to kill Luffy. And you also have a door, Doffy's going to be coming in for the kill. So yeah, there's a lot of variables right here that could go in any direction. But I don't personally believe that Luffy's going to be able to transform again. I really doubt Luffy's going to be able to go into his Gear 4 state again. I doubt that, because it was already shown. You could already see it's already affecting his body. Like, he seems very worn out. You saw when he put his hand on the ground, like when he was kind of detransforming from Gear 4. When he put his hand on the ground, he saw his arm kind of becoming wobbly. It's like his muscles were all fucked up and shit. So, yeah, clearly, from what we could see, it's really affecting Luffy's body pretty badly for even 10 minutes. That's a bad after effect. Really bad. He's like pretty much fucking useless for 10 minutes after he uses that. So, are we going to get to see Gear 5th? Are we going to get to see Luffy just sit out for the rest of the fight? Or is something else going to happen? I mean, is Law going to get up and start fighting? Because, I mean, Law does want to finish off Doffy. So, maybe Law might get the final shot in. Overall, this chapter, I have to say, it was a good chapter. A very, very explosive setup chapter that's hyping me up for next week. How do you all feel about this week's chapter? Did you enjoy it? Did you hate it? I love you all so much. You have a wonderful day, a wonderful night, wherever you live. Please be safe. Chibi out.